Hey, space friends. I haven't been posting a lot lately because I've been working on some really incredibly cool projects that I am totally going to be telling you about in a few weeks, and you will understand why. In the meantime, I have just arrived last night in Lead, South Dakota, which is right next to Deadwood, South Dakota. And I am here for an awesome, huge public event called Neutrino Day, which for me is just totally exciting because neutrinos are awesome, as you know, and I can't wait to geek out with a bunch of people about them. But what's really cool and what we're about to go see here is that we are at the site of Sanford Lab, which is the place of an abandoned gold mine that's actually detecting neutrinos that are being sent from Fermilab out in Chicago. So we're here at a neutrino detector that used to be this gold mine. So this town of miners has transformed into a town of particle physicists, which is incredibly cool. So I can't wait to see all of it, and I'm gonna bring you along with me. So let's go.
Services are limited, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Yates shaft. It's a wood structure. It started out to be a concrete steel structure, and then Hitler started raising heck over about 1938, and decided, oh, we're going to get involved in that, so we better take all the steel in America and make ships out of it. And the steel that was scheduled for this shaft, it went the same direction. So the engineers just switched gears. They put logging crews out in the timber, and bing, they just switched everything around and made it a wood shaft. It was that quick, and they just did it. You'll see that there's moisture in here, and this shaft is kept wet all the time. And that's for the structural integrity of the shaft, and so it doesn't rot real quick. This shaft was put into motion in 1939, and it's still pretty structurally sound today. You know, and it's safe enough so we can ride up and down it. That's pretty cool.
My dad was a miner down here in Homestake back when it was Homestake, and then was a safety guy in the lab when they opened up. He and I are kind of the bridge between the mining and the science. So this is a particle accelerator. When it's on, it does generate very small amounts of radiation, probably less than you get on the surface, but still, we are very careful about it. So you'll see a 3-inch thick lead door, very James Bond-esque entry into our accelerator. And here we are. We're recreating the conditions inside the heart of the star to understand how these processes actually take place in the universe. These are reactions that have been interesting to nuclear astrophysicists for 50, 60 years. We are the very first lab that will actually be able to do them at the energies they actually happen inside their stars. Because we're this far underground, we're able to suppress the background enough that we can actually see that. And it's exciting. We'll be the very first humans to ever actually understand that. You can tell I'm geeky.
So this right here is really the core of Casper. This is the accelerator itself. It's a Van de Graaff generator, Van de Graaff accelerator. You can look at this picture, you can see what it looks like inside of this black tank. So you know, it looks like your garden variety death ray. It really just is a Van de Graaff generator. You know, one of those county fair staples where you put your hand on the dome and your hair stands up everywhere. This is basically that, only a little more industrial. So if this is a gun, I suppose you would call this the chamber. This is where the acceleration actually happens. And it shoots it down the barrel here, the stainless steel evacuated tube. You'll see vacuum pumps everywhere that actually suck all the air out of here because we don't want our particles running into air molecules and slowing down. There's giant magnets on the thing that actually help focus the particles. This is an analyzing magnet which turns the whole beam line 25 degrees. And the idea is that when you shoot your particles down this beam line, they're subjected to this incredibly strong magnetic field, and only the particles with exactly the right charge momentum ratio will make the exact 25 degree turn. Something that's too heavy or not charged enough will, you know, continue going straight, or at least not make the full 25 degrees, with something that's too much charge or too little mass will turn more than 25. So this basically makes sure that we have exactly the particles we want and exactly the energy we want.
My tour of the Sanford Underground Research Facility, and it was absolutely amazing getting to put on all of this gear and go deep underground, actually close to a mile underground, and getting to see all this amazing stuff and these caverns that have been dug out for an old gold mine but are now being utilized for science and a bunch of really cool particle physics and also biology. They're also searching for extremophiles and extreme forms of life that could exist deep underground that might inform us about how extreme forms of life might live deep underground on Mars and other places in our solar system. So it was an incredible experience getting to talk with collaborators and researchers across different disciplines and how miners and particle physicists are collaborating together, and people are really coming together all over the South Dakota community but also all around the world to help make this amazing science happen. It was an incredible experience. I am so happy that I got to bring you all along for the ride with me. And that's it for me this week, Space Friends. So remember to subscribe on YouTube. Also join my Patreon because it does actually help me being able to go on these amazing trips and take you along for the ride on them. And otherwise, I'll see you next time.